2018?
It's gonna be a tough battle. We gotta come out, start fast, like we've been doing all year, and just keep the foot on the pedal.
What is the evaluation of Alabama so far? As you guys can see it.
They're a big physical team, and the game's gonna be won at the line of scrimmage.
How cool was it to get a pep talk from Tim Tebow?
I mean, it was a pretty good experience, you know, a guy that's accomplished so much in his college career, and just him being able to come here and give us a couple words of advice.
What did you take from his message, though? What did you get anything that you remember now, I mean, from an inspirational standpoint?
Just make the most of your time in college, you know, because you only get so many years, and just accomplish everything you can.
Some would say that you're going to be the key for this upcoming game and not the quarterback play because you've been the steady hand all year. What would you say to that point?
I think the key to the game is just establishing the line of scrimmage. So, I mean, I think the key to the game would be the offensive line and defensive line.
What would you say about your quarterbacks in this game or Cardell in this game and what you expect from him and what do you about his matchup going against Alabama?
I don't expect anything less than what we got last game, just him coming out being poised and not making plays.
Ezekiel, there's a lot of guys in your recruiting class who are already playing huge roles on this team. I mean, you know, you and Jay and Darren and JT, I mean, there's a bunch of guys. When you decided to come to Ohio State, how much does who else is in your class matter? Did you, like, look around and see the other talent that you were coming in with? Did that help you make a decision to come here?
It matters a little bit, just, like, kind of just forming a relationship with the guys that you may be coming in with. But, I mean, I didn't play too huge of a role.
What do you think of what the guys in your class have done so far? Are you surprised at all that there's some guys who've only been here 2 years and what some guys are doing?
I think we've lived up to our expectations, you know, because my recruiter, he told all of us that we were going to come in and play, and a lot of us are making early impact.
Didn't Alabama made a late play for you, didn't they? Or they made a play for you, didn't they? Or was that just alone?
It was a late play.
It was a late play?
Yeah.
Did you actually talk to Coach Saban?
No, I didn't.
You did not?
No, I was coming in here.
Did you give them much credit, or did you give them much credence at all, though, when they made their late play?
No.
Just because it was Alabama?
No.
Do you have what, in another situation, might be considered SEC speed?
What exactly is SEC speed?
Yeah, I guess that's what
I think we have great speed on our team.
Is your family going to the game? And if they aren't, or if you know people who aren't, players' families who aren't, how do you feel for them in terms of the NCAA maybe possibly helping them get to the game?
My family, they make it to every game. So, I mean, I know it's sometimes tough, but they always find a way to make it happen. And I think the NCAA should do whatever they can to help families make it to the games.
Why do you say that? What does it do having your family there and that sort of thing?
You know, just like they are the one reasons I'm here now. And them not being able to have a chance to come see me play is kind of not fair.
Did you hear about the $800 that Ohio State is going to reimburse families? Do you think that's a good gesture?
I think it's definitely a good gesture, but it's not enough. I mean, the trip's going to be way more expensive than that.
Right.
And I know not every family is fortunate enough to be able to have the funds to make that trip.
And if you advance, can you imagine everybody trying to pay that even more the next time,
right.
10 days later?
Well, I think a lot of families won't be able to.
Hey, Zeke, you guys have, for the past, you know, 2-3 years now, ever since Urban's been here, been able to wear teams down. You have deeper, superior talent just based on the way that Urban's recruited. Now that you guys are going to be facing an Alabama team that has recruited to the same caliber, maybe even a little bit better in some people's eyes, how different do you think it's going to be playing a team that's across the board with depth and talent equals of you instead of you guys being a little bit better?
It's just going to come pure will, so whichever team is the toughest mentally and physically, you win the game.
Can you tell us what some of the conversations between you and JT and you and Braxton have been ever since Cardell has taken over now with those injuries?
Just go out there, you know, just keep playing hard, finish this season off strong. Everyone wants to win the national championship this year. So, I mean, Braxton and JT, they're right there with us.
Can you describe their mood, how they're acting? I mean, obviously, are there any down times for them or in terms of emotionally because they're not playing in this game?
I mean, yeah. I mean, any athlete not being able to be out there with their boys, their family, we're gonna feel some pain. But they happy for us. They're here for us, and they're continuing their leadership roles.
Is there more material on the bulletin board this week than there usually is?
He said, yeah.
Is there more material on the bulletin board than usual right now, Zeke? I mean, because you're an underdog, and Urban seems to really be able to get guys to play really hard when they're the underdog. So what's he doing?
Just the same approach. I don't think they're going to change the approach. We attack every game the same way. We've been underdogs this season. I mean, a lot of people haven't believed in us. If it was losing Braxton or losing JT, and no one's really, I mean, a lot of people have lost faith in us. And, I mean, all we have is each other, and we're going to keep this whole brotherhood together, and we're going to keep grinding and keep pushing.
How did you guys survive all that? Was it just your closeness, or a lot to do with the coaching staff, or what do you think? How you got through all the quarterback injuries and everything?
I think it's the closeness of our family. You know, we're truly a family. We've been through so much together, and I mean, it's gonna take a lot to tear us apart. So,
Zeke, you know, you started the year with a cast on your left wrist. You don't still wear that now, do you?
No, I still wear it.
You do still wear it. Does it inhibit you at all?
Yeah, definitely does. I can't carry the ball on my left wrist.
Still. Yeah.
I'm probably end up getting surgery again after the season.
Yeah, as the year went on, what did you feel different just about the way you were running, the way you were operating behind that offensive line and stuff? Did you start to feel more fluid? I mean, what? Just explain that little metamorphosis from the beginning of the year as a first-time starter to the end when you were seeing things.
Definitely more fluid, you know, just with more game experience and just more chemistry, things clicking more with the O-line, just everything hitting right. With timing and everything.
You know, you've got, like right now, I think the 11th best rushing year ever for an Ohio State running back. What does that mean to you?
It means a lot, you know what I'm saying? All the great running backs that have came through here, the running back pedigree is just ridiculous. So, I mean, it's kind of crazy just to think about it, but I got no one to think about my O-line. They've paved the way.
See, because say, you know, you're facing a defense that prides itself on stopping to run Alabama. You know, they kind of set the standard almost and stuff. Do you see this? What kind of challenge will this be for you guys, do you think, to keep it going, so to speak?
It'll definitely be a challenge. They have a lot of big interior defenses. Their line and linebackers are just big guys. And so
two more questions for
this is going to be our will versus their will.
Why are people predicting that you won't win this game?
If they don't believe in us, I mean, we don't really need them to believe in us, honestly. Like I said, people have been against us all year. No one thought we'd make it to the Final Four. And, I mean, we've put it wrong, and we're going to keep pushing.
See, because this is a seize-the-moment type of game for you guys, and you guys have heard the comparisons between the Big Ten and the SEC. Best team from the SEC, best team from the Big Ten, maybe the best team in college football in Alabama. Is this a sort of a put-up or shut-up type of moment for this program right now?
It's definitely a game where it's gonna, a statement will be made. You know, the Big Ten looked at as one of the weaker conferences. The SEC has been looked at as the most dominant one, so... I mean, just we have a lot to prove in this game.
You ever been to New Orleans?
Yeah, I've been to New Orleans.
You like the town? It's crazy place.
Well, it's a nice little town. I actually used to live in Baton Rouge for a couple of years, and I was actually in New Orleans, I think, like maybe after my junior year in high school for a national track meet. So.
You like the food? Do you eat that stuff? All the crazy.
Oh yeah.
And the gumbo.
Yeah,
and
I love gumbo.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Did you go to Bourbon Street?
No, I haven't been to Bourbon Street.
I'm curious, do you know how many rushing touchdowns Alabama has given up total this year?
No, I don't.
Okay. It's three.
It's three?
Yeah.
Okay.
Will you be? I was just curious if that's the kind of thing that you know going into the game.
I mean, I don't really pay attention to what happened before. I mean, obviously you watch film, but like...
Stats don't mean anything.
You really don't.
Will you be an even better back when your wrist is... completely back and you don't have to wear that?
I think there'll be a lot of things that will improve, just like breaking tackles and things. I've left a lot of yards on the field this year just because of my wrist. I can't carry the ball on my left hand. I can't really use my stiff arm, so I can't really use my hand to post on the ground. So, I mean, I've left a lot of yards on the field, something that we're going to improve on next year.
Obviously, that's pretty good. The year you had production. Leaving that many yards on the field. You feel good about that, what you've been able to do, even with maybe not being 100%?
Yeah, I do.
Obviously, Cardell had a strong first game. Where can he get better?
I mean, he didn't really make many mistakes in that game. So, I mean, just trying to build on what he did.
What's he been like? What's been different about him since he rose to become the starter now? What's different about him, Zeke?
I mean, he's matured a lot coming up to this year, but I've seen like even a lot of more maturity in the past couple of weeks, just with him being a starter. And I mean, he was ready for this moment. I think he's going to continue the season.
How do you describe that maturity? What did he do? What did he say? How do you qualify that?
Just the way he acts. You know, he's just a lot more of a leader. I mean, he has to be. He's the quarterback of our team, so.
Does he sound like somebody who knows what he's talking about, though, when he speaks? You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, he does.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. How much difference does it make when he's the starter and he's talking?
Man, I think just like after the last game, it's a lot of added confidence. And so, I mean, when you get some confidence behind you, you kind of, kind of carry yourself a different way.
Yeah. Does he speak to the team, to the offense before the game the same way JT did?
Actually, JT gave us our pregame speech last game, so. I mean, like I said, those him and Brad, they've been there, continuing their leadership roles.
What was the gist of that speech from JT?
I mean, just everything that's led up to this point would mean nothing if we didn't finish what we had to do in Indianapolis.
You giving us a prediction?
Not my power to do that.
Is this how you tie your cleats? I can understand why your shoes come off in games if this is how you
play. No, I tie my cleats up. I think my shoe came off because a guy, maybe his helmet or his foot, something hit it. So my shoe just slid off.
Have you heard from Keith Byers since then?
I have not.
You know what I'm talking about.
I have not. Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
How's Bosa been now that he's a unanimous
last
All-American?
Question.
Bosa, I mean, he's the same old Bosa, same guy, so nothing's really changed.
What does that mean, same old Bosa, though? What does that mean to you, if you had to define it?
Sarcastic. Joey, I mean, like you guys probably know, we're best friends, so.
Yeah.
I mean, we spent a lot of time together with roommates. No, I mean, it's the same old guy. Nothing's changed. He's a grinder still, works hard.
Thanks, man.
All right. Everybody, you guys get out of here now.